cities of France, and close to Nice, there is the city of Grasse, which is a famous spot for the fragrance industry. Because historically, in this city, they developed a very nice knowledge on the transformation and the production of aromatic plants for the formulation of perfumes. So basically, starting from aromatic plants and doing the extraction and the distillation, they can produce absolutes, concretes, so the extract, and the essential oils that can be used to create perfumes. And for chemists, this kind of raw materials are extremely interesting because if you look at the chemical literature, you can see that you can find many, many data on the composition of these raw materials. But in contrast, the number of studies which pinpoint the components of these mixtures, which are of a complex mixture, so the components of these mixtures which participate to the odor is much less common. And if you are lucky enough to find some information, you can often see that there are many controversies. And this is simply due to the fact that the olfactory system, the human nose, is a very fuzzy detector because it is both extremely selective and extremely sensitive. So it is extremely sensitive because we are able to detect some components at a very low concentration, while on the other hand, it's very selective because some other components are almost odorless. The best example is of course water, which is totally odorless when it's pure. And this is the main reason why it's extremely difficult to say, to answer to this question, what's in the mixture, what's in the essential oil, what are the components which participate to the odor. And for the to give some answer, a very nice technique is gas chromatography olfactometry, GCO. So it's it was the system we used in our study on frankincense, and I would like just to briefly the principle, because it's rather easy to understand. So just imagine that you have a mixture to analyze, you inject it in the column of a chromatograph, then it is directed to the physical detector and it produces the chromatograph. And if the other part of the flow is directed to the nose of an operator who smells and describes his olfactory perception and function of the time, then it is possible to attribute an odor to each of the constituents individualized on the chromatograph. And in fact, it's funny because this technique is very old. It's probably as old as gas chromatography itself,